Coming to you live from the contaminated dungeon, it's Max the Animal and Nikki Snacks here on Bagels and Locks.
Good morning, and welcome to Bagels and Locks. I'm your host, Max the Animal, joined by my partner, Nikki Snacks. And as always, we will be giving you our best bets for this week's NFL action.
Wildcard weekend.
There you go. You nailed those words. I don't know what you're going to say.
Come on.
Say
my first rodeo.
I know. And you know how I know that? This guy went 3-0 last week. Look at him. And on this show, when you go 3-0, you dress 3-0. So, as you can see, our man is sporting a navy blue suit with a
maroon turtleneck.
It's turtleneck season.
It is turtleneck season. You're going to be seeing a lot of them soon.
I, on the other hand, did not go 3-0, went 1-2.
As you can tell by his wardrobe. No, it's nice. I'm just saying, you're not in a suit. Or really nice clothing.
So, yeah, so I went 1-2. Not a good week. You know what happened? The Eagles really kind of screwed me there. I didn't know that they were going to be resting starters. I know all this, the line moved 5 points. It was a disaster. We're over it. We're on to this week. We're on to the
wild
card.
Well, it should
make
you feel better that they wouldn't have even covered the 5.5 that after the...
Yeah, but I think if Jalen Hurts stays in the game, it's a different story. Yeah, exactly.
You also picked the Cowboys. I told you not to, but whatever. What are you going to do? You're right.
Whatever. It happens.
It's in the past.
It's a new week. I'll be in a suit next week because I'm going to go 3-0 this week.
Bookmark that.
31-21-1 on the season, 28-24-1 on the season. Who are you going to trust?
The one that's hotter.
He's been hot. But I'm going to get hot right now. Here we go. First pick of the wild card weekend. We got the Rams at Seattle Seahawks, -3. We are taking the Seahawks, and here's why.
Tell us.
I don't know if, like, Jared Goff is going to be healthy. Like, they say, like, he got his thumb surgery and he's going to be okay and ready to go. But I don't believe that. You can't convince you. Can't bullshit a bullshitter. I ain't going to buy it. I'm not buying it. I don't care if he's 100%. He's ready to go. -3. This is,
fishy.
No, I think it's just too easy here. I mean, the Seahawks.
That's why it's fishy.
They smashed the Rams the last time they played. 20-9, I think it was. That covers the spread if you don't know math. Seahawks are a playoff team, too. They're a playoff team. Russ plays better in the playoffs. If you look at the history of Russell Wilson's playoffs.
Yeah, they're a playoff team. This is the playoffs.
No, but, like, they play better in the playoffs. Like, they're the playoffs.
They're a team that plays. I got you.
You know what I'm saying?
I got you.
Like, Russ has been. He's been bad. He's been.
Yeah.
Like, he started off the season cooking.
He was the MVP after 6 weeks.
Yeah, not anymore. But now he's coming back. He's going to say, hey, everybody, don't forget about me. I'm Russell Wilson. -3, Seahawks.
Not bad.
Boom, boom.
It almost seems too easy. That's why I think it's a good pick, which I shouldn't think that.
I think you don't overthink it in the playoffs.
You're right. But I'm going to overthink this one. And for some reason, the Bills, this steamrolling Bills, bulldozing everything in sight, scoring 50, scoring 40. That's an offensive juggernaut. But the Colts are really good. They're really good. Do I trust Phillip Rivers? No. Is he a first ballot Hall of Famer? No. Is he a Hall of Famer? No. Eli's better. However, I think the Colts cover the 6.5. I'm taking the Colts plus 6.5. I think this is the best team the Bills have played in quite a while. The Colts are very good. They've won 5 out of 6, and their last loss was against the Steelers that they just completely melted down. Completely. They were up 21-7. This Bills team is going to be...
Took the Steelers that week.
Huh?
Took the Steelers that
week.
There
you go. Sharp. That's nice. Yeah, nice. Anyway, this is a very good Colts team. Very good defense. Very good offense. The Bills defense is not good, by the way. I don't know why. Like, they used to be so stout. They're not anymore.
It's not their identity right now.
It's not their identity, which is nuts, but... I think the Colts control the ground game. They control the time of possession, force a turnover or two. They cover the 6.5. Colts plus 6.5. Lock it the f*** in right now. Do it now.
Interesting.
What do you mean interesting?
You know, because before the show, we were talking.
You were on the Bills.
I was on the Bills.
Yeah.
I was on the Bills. But I'm not on the Bills right now.
Things change.
I'm on to Tampa Bay at Washington football team. What? They're in the playoffs? That's crazy. -7.5 Tampa Bay. It's Tom Brady in the playoffs. It's Tom Brady in the playoffs. Why am I going to bet against him, especially with they got a hurt Alex Smith or Taylor Heineke? Let's go. Taylor or Tom? Tom. Taylor or Alex Smith? Kind of Alex Smith, who's like half healthy. This is such an easy pick. I get it. Like, it's the playoffs, so they don't want to make this, like, you know, -12.5. They don't want to do that. But the Bucs are going to win by 2 touchdowns. They're going to win by 2 touchdowns. They're going to embarrass the Washington football team on their home field.
Wow.
Tom Brady in the playoffs, don't bet against him. And don't overthink it. It's simple. Like, this is the playoffs, like we said. Just don't overthink it. Like, Tom Brady, wild card round. Like, when was the last time he even played in a wild card round?
Last year.
Was it, though? Was that true? Is that true?
The Titans beat them in Foxborough, so last year, yeah. And then they went to go play Baltimore.
He was not good in wild card rounds. Hold on a second. Let me think about this. -7.5. Carry the Tom Brady and the Bruce. Tom Brady, Tampa Bay, -7.5. We're still in it. We're feeling good. Lock it in.
I don't think you feel good. I think you're hesitating now, which is okay. It happens. Go with your gut. That's your gut, right? That's your gut. Go with
the gut. That's
why I
said don't overthink it.
I overthink everything. So last week I gave you 2 overs in week 17. They hit with ease. This week, I'm going to give you an under. And we're going Tennessee-Baltimore under 54.5. That number is so high to me, and I get why. Tennessee's defense, an atrocity. Baltimore can score the ball. They can go up and down the field. But you look at last year's playoff game, it's the same team. The same play. Everything's essentially the same, and the game is 28-12. They played earlier in the year, and the game was 30-24, and they needed 6 points in overtime to even get to 54. Neither one of those games went over 54.5. So, by process of elimination, I'm going to go under 54.5 in Tennessee-Baltimore. I think Tennessee tries to run the ball. All Baltimore knows how to do is run the ball. I think a lot of clock eating happens, and the total goes under 54.5. And I f***ing hate unders, so you know it's killing this show that we're taking an under. Killing it, because we like overs. We love overs, but we're going under. 54.5.
It's your pick. What do you mean, what is
54.5. Tennessee, Baltimore, lock it in. And if you want to do a teaser, tease it up. Go on.
All right, now, before we do the big locks, normally we do a big dog pick of the week, but instead, we're doing something a little different this week because we can. Snacks, just take a look at this real quick and make sure you pick one of these. Yeah, the matchups. I already have mine. I forgot to do the pre-show, but don't worry about it. So that's mine.
Bills Packers.
Yes. So mine, you can find these odds on FanDuel, by the way. I'm going with the Buffalo Bills versus the Green Bay Packers in the Super Bowl for +1,200. That's the matchup I'm choosing. I think those two teams will make it, so that's why I'm picking them. Listen, I think Buffalo's going to upset Kansas City. Is going to happen. I think they're going to lose this year. Kansas City not going to make the Super Bowl. Big Bills, Super Bowl. I want to see it happen just for the city of Buffalo.
I'm with you.
I wish
they were fans.
They'll go nuts. They'll break every table in within 20 miles.
I'm so upset that the Bills Mafia is not like assembled. But I'm going to go. This was my preseason pick, so I'm going to stick with it. And the value's not as good as Animals. Bills Packers, but I'm going to go +600 Chiefs Saints. That's what I think. I finally think the Saints overcome all these stupid bullshit referee obstacles and they finally get past the NFC. They go to the championship. I'm rooting for Buffalo. I am. I want Buffalo, but I'm still going to take Mahomes on his home turf with Andy Reid, Tyreek Hill, Travis Kelce. And I'll probably take the over in that game when it happens. But
I feel better about the Chiefs side than the Saints, man.
I know. I think Drew Brees, this is Drew Brees' final year. I think he goes out and he's in the Super Bowl.
If anything, the NFL is going to help him probably as much as possible.
That's what I'm saying. After the last 2 or 3 years when they've gotten f***ing anally screwed.
The last hurrah.
You know, my grandfather served in the military. Can't think. Hey, no.
Drew off into the breeze.
Yeah, that's good. Yeah, it's pretty good. Yeah. But I'm going Chiefs, Saints, plus 600. My matchup for the Super Bowl.
You can find those on FanDuel. I don't know what it's called, but, I mean, just look for it. You'll find it. If you know how to gamble, you'll find it.
Super Bowl matchup.
Oh, you hear that sound?
No.
Well, there it is again.
Well, now I heard it.
Yeah, because it's time for the big lock. I wonder if I'm destroying the floor every time we do that.
You don't.
100%, right? Just like locks, metal falling onto the floor.
It could be worse, though. I mean, they are plastic bagels.
Could be knives. Anyway, it's time for the big locks. I'm going to give you mine first. It's simple. I'm going Browns at Steelers. We're taking the Steelers minus 5.5. Why, do you ask? Well, it's the Browns' first time in the playoffs in, like, ever. So, like, they don't even know what they're doing there. They also don't have their head coach.
That's a big loss.
That's a big loss, especially in a playoff game. Like, if this was a regular season game,
whatever,
I'd f*** around, maybe take the Browns. But playoff game, like, this is big boy shit here. Browns is, like, your first time. Like, this is, like, your first time going to school, but you didn't get a new outfit.
It's not bad. It could have been worse. Yeah.
Right? On the spot. On the spot, you know? Right?
Yeah. That's pretty good.
Browns made the playoffs. That is their victory. That's it. That's all they got. Like, the Browns made the playoffs. That's their win. The Steelers are going to get the real win now. They're going to go out there. They're going to crush the Browns. I'm going to say they win this game by 9.5 is what the line should be.
Wow.
It's 5.5. You're getting
it. So you're
going
to do some alternate spread?
I might fuck around and do a little alternate
spread.
You
know, just real quick, I like that pick a lot because without the head coach, without Stefanski, it's huge. He could script the first quarter. You know what I mean? Like, the first quarter could be scripted. After that, kind of screwed.
Once you get into the nitty-gritty and the football
right.
has to come out.
And everything changes.
It's time to play football! It's over.
I agree.
Chug it! Football! Oh, my God. Missed. I did it again. That's going to look really cool on camera.
Just missed.
Like, you might have to slow-mo that for the people at home. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Steelers minus 5.5.
It's a nice pick. I like it. So, I'm a hypocrite. I am. I said I'm going to give you one under, but I'm going to give you two. I'm going to give you two unders.
He is.
Yeah, it's a second under. We went under in the Tennessee-Baltimore game. Playoffs is just different to me. I think defense shows up. I think the running game, that's kind of what playoff football is to me, and that's how I see it. So, like you said, we don't know who's playing quarterback for the Rams. We have no idea. Who are they going to rely on? Their defense.
Well, I mean, it's Goff or Walford. We have an idea.
Obviously, we know. I'm saying who starts.
Well, yeah.
It's obviously one or the other. But either way, I still like under 42.5. Los Angeles' defense is very good. Seattle's defense is playing very good. So, when you have a banged-up Goff or a backup in who?
Wofford.
Isn't that a college?
It could be. I think it might be.
Yeah, I think it's a college. I think I bet they're overs in, like, the 12 o'clock games on a Wednesday. But either way, we're going to go under 42.5. The defense is stout for the Rams. Seattle's defense is playing very well. The only way the Rams have a chance is if they stop Seattle, and I think they do. Seattle's offense has not looked good. They just played. It was, 23-9, like you said. That's, if you can do the math, that's well under. So, 42.5 under Rams, Seattle. Lock it in. Fuck it. Throw the key out. Never talk to her again. Rams, Seattle, under 42.5. And I have no idea what that meant. Just take the under.
Yeah. All right, interesting. Interesting picks from Snack.
Well, don't say interesting. I'm coming off 3-0. So just say good picks.
Picks from myself. Listen, if you also, maybe some of you watch the show and you can't gamble in your state.
That sucks. Move.
It might, well, you know, if you can't move at the time, you should go over to monkeyknifefight.com. And see if you can play in your state, because it is available in a lot of states where you can't gamble at your regular sports books. So you go to monkeyknifefight.com, you can play some fun games, you use the promo code BDGE, and you get a 50 $100 deposit, 100% deposit match up to $50.
So put it in. So put it in, and they have great props. You can do touchdown dances like we've done here. You do all these different things. So please sign up and do that. That's a great idea.
And that's the show.
Or DM me on Twitter. I'll take your action.
Please like, please subscribe. Thanks for watching Bagels and Locks.
Boom.
Bagels and Locks?